Defining energy turns out to be more difficult than what one might think. The high school physics definition of energy, the ability to do work, doesn't take us very far for what is ability and what is work. Robert Romer wrote a physics textbook which was about using energy concepts to understand all the conventional material of physics, because all physics is about energy. Yet, even he admitted that he was unable to give a satisfactory definition of energy. He said, "We can see energy's effects, we can measure them, but we don't really know what it is." Hello, my friends. Welcome to my Energy Economist channel. This is my first video, which is considered a citation to the channel. I affirm you that there will be at least 2 videos a week. So don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. We are going to start today by knowing what is energy. So stay with me. Energy is an abstract notion of mathematical nature which allows us to quantify the transformations of matter. Usually, we detect energy containing or transforming materials, food, petroleum, and oxygen. And energy being used because something is moved, a car, a basketball player, and so on. For our day-to-day experiences, energy is mostly found associated with either photons coming from the sun or the oxidation of fuels, such as wood or food or oil, that generates work at some point in space and time. These are things we can experience and understand pretty well, even if the physicists can't define them exactly, at least in a way that most of us can readily grasp. Energy runs the world, figuratively and literally. Its effects are pervasive, relentless, and all-encompassing. While one can't see energy, we can readily see its effect in transforming matter. What does this mean? It means we can readily and frequently observe the effects of energy transforming matter. You will your feet to go up the stairs, and they do, lifting your body mass and generating heat. We can drop a stone from the top of a tower and watch it fall. Thus, we mostly don't observe energy directly, but rather examine the effects of energy in transforming matter. Most of the energy around us is bound up in some kind of matter contained in elevated rocks or water, the chemical bonds of wood or coal or food, warmer spaces inside our homes or other buildings, and so on. And we can readily observe bound energy being transformed into motion by watching cars zoom down the highway. We don't live on energy, we live on transforming matter around us. One way of visualizing the notion is to ask how much matter has to be processed in order to deliver or consume a given amount of energy. The answer depends, of course, on the type of energy and the interactions involved in the process. The more intense the energy interaction involved, the less matter will be necessary. For example, an energy transaction of 1 kilowatt equivalent to 3.6 megajoule corresponds to 10 tons of water running down a medium-sized hydroelectric plant. The combustion of 1 kilogram of fossil fuel, the fission of 1 milligram of uranium in a nuclear plant. Coming back to the simple definition of energy as the ability to do work, still seems somewhat vague and inadequate. For what is work? Does this include heat? Well, the molecules are moving faster, most simply, but imperfectly, to the physicist, work occurs when something is moved. This energy, whatever that is, applied to transforming matter, is what causes motion to occur. Energy is experienced by humans, most often as photons flowing from the sun, or byproducts of the energy associated with those photons. We can see the atmosphere respond to this energy input as summer cumulus clouds rise in the atmosphere. We can watch water slowly disappear from a pool. We can watch plants in our garden grow day to day. As some small part of this photon flux is captured by plants through photosynthesis and stored as reduced chemical bonds associated with carbon. Then we can watch animals grow as they eat plants, or other animals built with the energy of the plant, as that energy is passed as electrons associated with hydrogen through food chains to an electron acceptor, such as oxygen. Likewise, when we drive an automobile, we are oxidizing oil that is constructed of high energy chemical bonds, originally made with energy captured from the sun by algae, but then processed over some 100 million years of geological pressure cooking. Energy is a capacity to do work. In the physics field, work is something resulting from the action of a force, such as that of gravity. In nature, there are different types of energy. The most classic case is solar energy, and all that energies come from the universe in the form of cosmic rays, X-rays, gravitational waves, dark matter, etc. A system that produces energy can be represented from a kite that floats in the clouds by means of wind, or a wave of light is passing through a space according to the energy conservation law. For example, one of the first laws of thermodynamics: the total energy of a system is conserved, although it can be transformed into another form. If you want to learn more about energy definition, you could do so in my book, Economics of Petroleum, The Principles, which is published on Amazon. Check it out at the link in the description. Please, take a second to hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and don't forget to also hit the notification bell. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.